Hey y'all, my name is Ann Glaviano, and I DJ a party called HEATWAVE in New Orleans. It's all vinyl 1957 to 1974 dance jams. In the first week of quarantine, when I was starting to get really sad, I made myself stop reading the news and go mow the lawn, and while I was mowing the lawn, I realized that that this was the moment that I have been waiting for years to make my wildest line dance fantasies at HEATWAVE come true. While everyone is trapped in quarantine and I can't DJ really for a room full of people anyway, it seems like a great opportunity to teach you a line dance via video, and you can practice at home. And then we have something to look forward to at the end of this, which is that we maybe will all have learned this dance together, and we can do it when we're all in a room. I just thought that would be really joyful. I think I'm going to do two. I think I'm going to do the Madison now, and I think I might have a surprise in store later. Most line dances have a repeating pattern, so there'll be a few eight counts of steps, like the electric slide, and you do it this way, you know, and you do it, and then the steps turn you, and then you do it facing this wall, and then it turns, and you do it facing the back wall until you make this box. But it's the same steps, like it's just the sequence, and it just rotates and it rotates and rotates, and that means that if you are on the dance floor and a bunch of people start doing a line dance, even if you've never seen it before, there's a chance, if you're a pretty quick study, that you could pick it up. Well, that's not possible with the Madison. The Madison doesn't work that way. It has a repeating step, and then interspersed, there are other moves. In my, like, naive understanding of what a square dance, like a hoedown, where there's a caller, there's, like, a guy on the mic, and he's shouting to people, now swing your partner round and round, now do-si-do. So there's like a band playing, there's a guy on the mic calling out the steps, and then the dancers change what they're doing in response to what the caller calls out. So that's how the Madison worked, there, from the research that I've done. So it seems to have started in Columbus. It was, from what I've read, I saw, like, a news clipping, like, just black kids at a community center, who invented these moves, and they would form clubs, and it became, like, a worldwide thing. It's a little bit like, Fortnite, I guess, that video game that, like, my little cousins are obsessed with, or at least the dance moves from this video game, or, like, flossing for little kids or like preteens 5 years ago, I guess. Flossing's kind of like old hat now, I guess. Or like the Carlton from Fresh Prince. There are these moves that you observe in pop culture or that you name after a pop culture reference, and then it becomes a fad. So these teenagers in the 60s would come up with moves based on pop culture references at the time, and they had their own clubs, and they would come up with their own moves, and then they would have, like, these competitions, Madison competitions. My sense of it is there was a proliferation of versions of the Madison depending on what kinds of steps your group of friends came up with. The way that it has been sort of preserved over time is that there's the musical recordings of the song Madison Time. There's like two kind of main recordings. The Ray Bryant Trio has a guy on the mic calling out these steps. And so the steps that we know in 2020 from this dance that was invented in the early 60s, or maybe late 50s, I have to look, are the steps that this particular caller, the day they made that recording, the ones that he said into the mic, those are the steps that we know were in the Madison. But they may have had many, 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 many more steps that were done to this dance. It's just that the ones that are kind of preserved in amber are the ones on this recording. What did those steps look like? We know through a kind of oral tradition the way that all dances are passed along through time. You know, you learn it from the people who learned it before you, and things get lost in translation. So that's part of it. We can assume that John Waters did his research when he made the movie Hairspray, and that the way the dance is represented in that movie is hopefully pretty accurate. But there are things about that movie, like that movie set in Baltimore. The song makes reference to the Cleveland Box. Well, in the cut of Hairspray, where they're doing the Madison, they cut out that part of the song. They don't say anything about the Cleveland Box. I assume it's because the movie's like set in Baltimore and they just didn't want a reference to Cleveland in there because maybe it would be confusing. I've had to cobble together over looking at other sources to see, like, well, what would the Cleveland Box had looked like? And there's kind of consensus among all of the different versions of it that I've seen. What we mostly don't know, the traditional jazz community, like the swing community, does the Madison, so there's a lot of swing kids who know how to do it, but I've seen a lot of recordings of the Madison where they get to the last step, which is the Birdland, and they just walk around like chickens, and that is not it. I am like pretty confident. So I did tons and tons of research, and I found like a social dance video of this like older black couple doing something that that they said was the Birdland, which was a jazz club, right? I mean, that's a pop culture reference too. And the way that this couple was moving their legs, it seemed to line up. And I've subsequently seen other recordings where the dancers doing the Birdland part of the Madison, it looks like what I had cobbled together. All right, I guess we'll start. I'm sorry if the camera quality isn't incredible. My face might be kind of blurry, but you don't really need to see my face. You just need to see my legs. The first step in the Madison is called the Madison. It's the foundational step. It repeats a million times, and it's very short. The first thing you do is you step on your left leg, and you clap. Then you step back on your right leg where you came from, and you go touch, touch, touch. That's it. Step, clap, step, touch, touch, touch. When I was teaching this in Ohio, I had friends who had a little bit of a hard time balancing on this leg while doing this crossy stuff. So I guess my advice to you would be to think about really standing on this leg and really standing on this leg. And everything else that happens is sort of dressing. But these are the actions. Step, step, step. Step, step, step. Right? So it's left leg, right leg. Left leg, right leg. Really make sure your weight is over each leg that you're standing on so you can balance. So the cool thing about this dance is that you don't actually have to remember the steps in sequence, because as you're vamping on this foundational step, he's gonna call out the next step, he's gonna articulate all of the parts of it, and then he's gonna say hit it. So you don't have to remember, you just have to listen. So two up in this dance means two steps forward. And by a step, he means step touch. So two up is step touch, step touch. Two back is step touch, step touch. So I'm going left together, left together, right together, right together. The strong turn looks like this. You're gonna go boop, 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 boop. So what I did was step on my left foot, touch. Step on my right foot, little snappy thing. Step on my left foot, touch, right foot, snappy guy. So two up, two back. And we're gonna go step, touch, step, touch, and back to the Madison. So I'm gonna play the music, and we'll do that much together with the guy. He's really funny.
He calls out all this encouragement while you're doing it. He keeps making reference to the big, strong line, because this is meant to be done in a line. It's a line dance, right? So it's like all these people standing in a row doing this dance together. And he wants to see a big, strong line. And then he says, like, "You're looking good." It's so sweet. It includes a step called the Rifleman, which is a TV show. It involves pretending like you're firing rifle. I have fired a rifle before, like in my childhood. I am from Louisiana. I don't think it looks like I'm doing a very good job firing a rifle. I apologize in advance. So you're back to the Madison. He's going to say, "I want you to go two up, two back, double cross, and then something, something to the Rifleman." So as you already know, two up looks like this. Two up, two back, double cross looks like this. You're going to step on your left foot and just kind of pick up your right foot and bring it over. Step on the right foot, left foot, right foot. All right? You're one, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. Step, cross, step, cross, step, cross, step, cross. So you've gone here, bump, 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 bump. He says, "Hit it." You're gonna go two up, two back. You've got your step. Cross, 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 cross. You're gonna cross one more time. Cross, your weight's on your left foot. You're gonna hop back three times. Boom, boom, boom. Now this is your, like, cock your rifle and then step forward, boom. And that's the replacement step for what would have been your Madison forward. So you go, you're here, boom, step, touch, touch, touch. So again, you're Madison, two up, two back, double cross, right man. And then he goes, "Hit it." And you go two up, two back, step, cross, 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 one more cross, cross, hop. Hop, boom, boom. Bop, bop, bop. Bop, bop, bop. Let's see if I can slow down the little coda at the end. So you've done two up, left, right, left, right, two back, right, left, right, left. The cross is step left, cross right, step right, cross left, cross right, cross left, left, hop. Hop, hop, cock your rifle. I'm not good at this. Forward with it. I don't know, make a gesture like you're firing a cannon. And then back to Madison. Boom. And again, note that you're a rifleman. You've gone hop, 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 back, boom. And that's your forward step that takes you here. In lieu of the clap. Alright, so let's try all of that now with music. And again, if you need time to think about it, rewind video, try it again, and then meet me in the next segment where we try all three. Madison, the first step with the turn, the big strong turn, and then the Rifleman. this one is easy. So I feel like the last two, it's like you have to learn what kind of like new concepts. This one, you know the concepts, and it eats up a whole chunk of the song, and so this is like where you get to coast. It's the M. And so you're doing your Madison, right? And he's like, do your big strong M and erase it. And that means you're going to take your two up step, touch, and you're going to trace the letter M on the floor as if you were writing an M, boop, 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 boop. So the pathway is straight forward, back diagonal, front diagonal, straight back. Then he's like, erase it, and you're gonna go this way, this diagonal, back. So that's just the pathway. So can you visualize this? This is an M, where you're going to erase it by retracing your steps. And it's the movement is step, touch, step, touch. Step, touch, step, touch. Step, touch, step, touch. Step, touch, step, touch. Erase it. I'm going to say the feet that I'm using. Left, right, left, right. Right, left, right, left. Left, right, left, right. Right, left, right, left. I will note, especially in the movie Hairspray, it looks way cooler when you turn your head to face the direction that you're going. So you're starting off, you're in your Madison. Boom, 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 boom. And he's like, hey, you're gonna do the M, what's your big strong M? Erase it, and back to the Madison. All right, hit it. You're gonna look straight forward. You don't have to snap, but it's nice. So you're looking straight forward, and you're gonna go to this diagonal, you're gonna look towards that diagonal. So that there's a real shift in the facing of your body, depending on which way you're going. This way, this way. It just makes it kind of crisp. And when everyone does it together, it looks really cool. All right, so you're traversing this with these little side steps. Side step, side step, side step. Erase it, side step. Side step, and then you go back to the Madison, but you knew that already. This next one's really funny. It's called Tea Time. You have two options. So you're Madisoning. He's like, now when I say hit it, it's gonna be tea time. Hit it. You're gonna go two up, as you already know. One, two, three, four. All right, option one, you jump and you make a letter T with your body. And then you go two back to the Madison. So again, that looks like this. You're here. He's like, all right, it's gonna be tea time. Hit it. Step, touch, step, touch. Step, touch, step, touch. Back to the mat. One more time with your feet being named. You're here, Madison. He's like, it's going to be tee time. Hit it. You're going to go left, right, left, right, hop, right, left, right, left, back to the Madison. Okay? So that's option one. I've also seen people do it this way, but frankly, that doesn't make a letter T. This is not the letter T. This is the letter T. So I think we should just be really, you know, pure about this and make a T. The other option is to have the identical setup, but instead of making the shape of a T with your body, you can throw back a tiny cup of tea. So that would look like this. You're here, Madison, Madison, Madison. He's like, all right, now when I say hit it, it'll be tea time. Ready? Hit it. You're gonna go two up. Take a drink of tea, two back, and back to the mess. So, again, right, he's here, na 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 na. When I say hit it, it's gonna be tea time. Okay, hit it. Left, right. I'm holding my left hand as like a saucer, and my right hand is pinkies up like the mug. Boop, boop. Right, left, right, left, back to the Madison. Okay? All right, let's try to do all of that together now with the music.
It's Madison time, get it. You're looking good, a big strong amount. When I say it, I want you to go two up and two back.
All right, much like I don't know how to fire a rifle or even pantomime it, I don't know how to box, but the next step is the Cleveland box. So this is one that I had to kind of cobble together. Roughly it looks like this. So you're Madisoning, boom, 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 and he's like, all right, when I say hit it, we'll do the Cleveland box, back to Madison, hit it, you're going to step touch, your little two up step. While you're doing it, you're going to circle your hands like you're hitting a speed bag, kind of. Never done this ever in any kind of boxing context, but the the little teardrop bag. So that's the hands, and the feet go. He's like, hit it. We're gonna go on this diagonal, stepping with your left foot. Bump, 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 bump. Then we're going to go on this diagonal. So I'm going to trace basically a box on the floor like this. Okay. So it's kind of set on the diagonal, like so. And then you go back to the Madison. So you're here. Bump, 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 bump. He's like, hit it. You're like here. Back, you go back, you go kind of towards where you came from, hit it, you're gonna go left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, right, one more time. He says, hit it. You go. Left, right, left, right. Back this way. Right, left, right, left, this way. Left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left. And now your weight is still kind of on your right foot, so you can step left foot into the Madison. And you'll note that the reason that you start with your right foot and your left foot is dictated by which direction you're trying to travel. So you're here. We're going to go left. We need to go this way. Our right foot is the nearest one, so we're going to move here. Now we want to go that way. Our left foot is the nearest one, so we're going to go this way. And then we want to go back to where we came from. That's our right leg. And we know we want to Madison on our left leg. So that is how the Cleveland box works. All right. This time we're just going to pick up the music from the Cleveland box and do like the second half. We're about halfway done. And then he says, I want to see the big strong basketball with a Wilt Chamberlain hook. So you're going to go two up, but while you're two upping, you're going to pretend to dribble. So you're left, right, and you're going to take your dribbling hand, because that's where the basketball is. You're going to hook shot it, and then you're going to look forward, hold up two fingers, and say, 2 points. Like you scored a basketball goal. And he says it, and you'll say it with him, and it's hilarious. He says, I want to see a big strong basketball with a Wilt Chamberlain hook. Hit it. You're going to go left, right, huh. 2 points. Right, left, back to Madison. So you're doing your two up. It's interrupted by your hook, two back to Madison. So one more time, Madison. And then he says, hit it. You're gonna go two up, left, right, your right hand hook shot to the front. 2 points, two back, right foot first, right, left, back to Madison. So at speed, that looks like this. He says, hit it. You go, two, 2 points. Back to Madison. Cool. We'll do that with music. Alright, we're going to pick it up from the Cleveland box. Two more steps. This one is Jackie Gleason. Jackie Gleason was a comedian. And I suppose he had a catchphrase, and away we go. And he had a gesture that he did with it that was like, kind of like a Looney Tunes, like rearing up to like, and I think there actually may be a sculpture of him in this like posture. Anyway, that's the move. So much like things like the Carlton, you know, like everyone knows the, so I just think it's so cute. All right, So the way this works is you're Madisoning. He's like, you know, Jackie Gleason. You're gonna go two up. You're gonna cross your right leg. You're gonna kind of like scuff, wind up, jump on it, and away we go. And you're gonna go back to the Madison. So this involves a little bit of balance. He actually says, and away we go. You can say it with him. So you're Madison, Madison, Madison. You step left, right, left, right. You're two up as usual. Your weight is on your left foot. You've touched with your right foot. Pick up your right foot, scuff it, bring it across, a little wind up, and you're gonna kind of jump onto this leg, and away we go. And you're already kind of coming out of it once he says, away we go. Back. So, seeing it all the way through, it looks like this. You're gonna go, whoops, do that without falling over. You're gonna go two up, ha, 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 and away we go. Back to the mats. The transition out of it, you get two up, left, right, right. Bring it over, jump on your right foot, step back on your left foot, touch right. Step back, right foot, touch left. So it's just like your two back, but you kind of change your facing. So now my weight is on my right foot, my left foot is in a kind of the touch position so I can step on it to do the mats. One more time, looks like this. Step, touch, bring your right leg across, buh, and away, we left, right, left, huh, back to the Madison. Alright, we're gonna pick it up from tea time. This is the one that I had to sort of not invent, but do a lot of research because it's the Birdland, and what a lot of the documentation I've seen has people just completely dropping all of this and just like freestyling, chicken walking, and we're not gonna do that. So here is my approximation that I have sort of validated through finding other videos of steps that are called the Birdland, outside of the context of the Madison. It looks like this. If you think of your left leg as the pivot point, you're gonna kind of keep swinging, body half. So my right leg is the point around which my body is swiveling. But you're gonna make it look less ridiculous than that. So your Madison, and he's like, hit it, and your left leg's gonna be free. You're gonna pivot, touch, and you can do your little step out, and then you're gonna step, pivot, back, touch, So it is like your two up, two back, except it's fancier, because it's got this little swivel. So conceptually, you're still going two up, two back, but the fancy version is, here's your one up, two up, one back, two back. So left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left. Okay. This one I remember being tough for people to pick up, so just give it a minute. Thinking about this, the left leg as your like special pivot friend that you turn on. It's just a little half turn. And I guess if you need the mechanics of how you do that turn, for me, I pick up my heel. So I step on this foot, so I put my weight on it, but then I pick my heel up so that I can swivel on the ball of my foot. Touch the right foot, step, touch, and again, put my weight on my left foot, then I pick up my heel so I can pivot, touch. So pick up my heel, bop, huh, huh. Pick up my heel, huh. So that way you can turn easily. And he says something like, I have a little stiff leg in there. No idea what that's in reference to. I kind of imagine it in being reference to this pivot point. Right? Okay. So, you're Madisoning. He's like, Birdland. Hit it. Huh. Huh. Back to the Madison. And he says stop, and that's when you don't stop. We're taking it from tea time again. So the conclusion of the song, when he says, hit it, I'm still, at least in my version of this, he says, hit it, and I'm like here. So just in the next opportunity to step forward, I make it my Madison. So he's like, how about a little stiff leg in there? Don't know what that means. Keep doing the Birdland. You do it for a while. He's like, all right, come out of it. Hit it. So there's a little bit of a delay between when he says hit it and when you actually get your next Madison in. And then he says, it's a repeat of an earlier step. He's like, two up, two back, double cross, and hold it right there. So hit it. It's two up, you already know this. Two back, double cross. So this is step, cross, right, right, cross, left, step, cross, right, cross, left. And then he's like, hold it right there. And people sometimes do like a spin. Whatever, little tag ending you want to do. And it comes very quickly from this last Madison. So, one more time. You're here, you're Madisoning. He says, hit it. You are left, right, two back, right, left. Right, left, double cross, left, cross, right, right, cross, left, cross, left, right, cross, left, and then you're here, you can cross and unwind, hold it right there. You can, I mean, I don't, whatever. It's like your big finale, whatever brings you joy. And that's it. So we'll take it from the top. Yeah, here we go. All right, you guys, we're gonna put it all together. Turned up the volume so you get the full impact of the Ray Bryant Trio. I would say just remember that this is supposed to be done in a line. So a lot of these facings where you're going two up, you're imagining that there are people like next to you and you're all like kind of squeezed in together. So that's conceptually as you're doing this, imagine that you are part of a big strong line and you are looking good. Yes, that's my pep talk. Here we go.
It's Madison time. Hit it. You're looking good. A big strong line. When I say it, I want you to go two up and two back. With a big strong turn and back to the back.
Well, you guys, I'm really sweaty from dancing. That was really fun. I hope you enjoyed that. I know it's a real tricky one. You can see why it's basically impossible to learn on the dance floor. So I never play the Madison at HEATWAVE because I have no one to do it with. So please practice this and then do it with me next time we get to dance together. And it would just fill my heart with joy. Dancing together is one of my favorite things to do. It's actually why I DJ. I love the music. The music's really important to me, but the dancing is the best part. And the singing. I love the singing, too. Also, I love seeing y'all dancing to the playlists in Instagram stories. Like, I just think Instagram's maybe the easiest way to share that stuff instead of having to, like, send video files or whatever. But if you... if you do listen to the playlists and get your like groove on, or if you do practice the Madison and you feel like sharing it, if you post it in your stories and you tag me, and then I can share it from my stories and we can have kind of a central feed of everyone dancing together. It makes me so happy to see people dancing to that music. And I would love to see your Madison practice sessions. So Instagram is at Ann Glaviano. And if you don't tag me in the story, I can't share it from my account. So you'd have to tag me and I'm not good at that stuff, but that is my understanding. So yeah, share and tag so I can share us all doing this very weird historic line dance together. If you want to tip your DJ, I have a PayPal and a Venmo account. I can link to those. If you don't have it to tip, that's fine too. Just, you know, keep dancing and finding whatever diversions and pleasure you can find in this very strange time. I look forward to us all being able to be in a room together again. Have a great weekend, and I will be back next week with a playlist or maybe some other kind of strange offering. All right, you guys, I'll see you.